Oh, we made a thing.
They were up there.
I think you also had dinner for us.
How was this bridge?
Sorry, I should.
Everything's correct, but it makes sense to have origins later if you have no idea.
It's square.
Yeah.
So it's like, so it's like spaces in between. So like, those are the ones.
So it's like, these ones are black spaces and these ones are red spaces.
Oh. That makes sense. That's why.
Here, so like, you have this, and so this is black squares.
Oh, okay, sure. But then these white, so what?
Okay.
And that's what it looks like. These are white.
So X is a white.
So space, what space, what space, what space? So we know. Okay. So let's start from corners. And so the zookeeper comes down from every, then they all move, they have no room. You're trying to get to the opposite side, which I guess would be here. Where would you just step like diagonal off or the opposite side? I don't know. So we'll see.
So wait, who's the?
She's.
So are you guys trying to get the zookeeper?
Yes.
And then you're having six.
If we swap.
No, I'm moving to. So we need.
Yeah, she's the one.
Yes.
The zookeepers is trying to save themselves.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, okay.
Okay,
cool.
I didn't write it down.
Okay.
Yeah, it's in there. Okay.
All right, so let's run a playthrough
obeying that rule.
Yeah.
I was just like, so in the moment.
Is there anything that I missed that you guys saw?
There's the pointing thing.
Oh, the point, yeah.
Okay, there was some debate about that.
But it's not in the rules, so.
No, where's Brock? He was the one I argued with.
I think it's like.
He said no more, yes.
Are you using it?
Brock, one.
What I did?
You said no. Three, two.
I say.
You can go back.
Two, one.
You can't say.
Okay.
Three, two, one. Three, two, one. Three, two, one. Three, two, one.
Okay, all right. Did it look like I got it right?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Just a little hesitation on the first, one or first move or second, because you have to go exactly at the same time.
So how can we get our players to understand that they shouldn't hesitate if you've got anything?
You should probably say that, you know, that the orcas, or I guess, yeah, that the orcas cannot wait for their turn. They actually have to move.
But I think there's also an innate competitiveness and curiosity to see where everybody else's move is, and rather than commit to their move. So
if you close your eyes when you're busting, you can't actually observe
it. To that end, the rule we were kind of playing with is that the zookeeper counts down 3, 2, 1, and then everybody points where they're going to move, and that way you can't like hedge it. It's just like, I'm going that way at 0.
Does that sound like you guys would be willing to try that one?
Yes.
Sure. Right. Run through. Same players?
Yeah, you want to know
what I'm saying? Oh, yeah,
what's
going?
What?
Okay, more excellent.
What are you doing?
What are you talking about?
Oh, I'm told I am not being very important. I can't. Oh, I'm done. Oh, you're
so good.
You're
going to
die.
Watch your
Wow.
Here's some whale song chorus. Let's go.
Oh.
Alright. Three, two, one, go.
Oh, are we pointing or are we not
pointing? Yeah. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Are we supposed to point? Are we supposed to
point where we go now?
Yeah. Oh, you are? Yeah, I didn't hear that part.
Sorry.
So, immediately Yosha says, your team at one. Or he says one. Point to where. Does the zookeeper point?
Okay, 3, 2, 1, go. 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 3, 2, 1, go.
We were being really rigid with the constraint, rigorous with the constraint. So So, and trying not to use other props, things that might be interpreted as props, right? So they were obeying the letter and the spirit of the challenge. So,
string.
Yeah, we could do string that's reusable as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, you can talk about string for the volume.
Because we're in Colorado and we all climb mountains, we know that a long, long, long string is much more valuable than anything that's been cut to size. Because we can always just warn you. That's our sort of a meta layer level, how do we prototype space?
So in this instance, are we, is string in the same realm as tape where it's not actually
fine? I mean, I think in this one, I'd give the string a buy, I'd give the string a pass. But yeah, I mean, we're still trying to figure out, you know, what is a prop, what's not a prop, what is the environment? At some point, if something gets, hyperactive and hyperkinetic, we might move. These and all of a sudden it feels different because all of a sudden you understand that there's a barrier. And so that if you have something that has a swinging motion, right, so then we have to figure, okay, how are we defining the environment? How are we defining the prop? This won't necessarily be a prop. So something as simple as this, Richard, would it help you have perceived?
Yeah, it would.
Now, so those were all aids in terms of the documentation presentation. What about the gameplay itself? Do you have any suggestions for the gameplay?
I think it's bound between how the game does and viewers movement and the orca, very rigid, current direction can go immediately back at this nice layer of, there's three orcas and they're kind of sort of trying to communicate with what they're trying to do. Because they're more confined, or there's more of them, or do you have more freedom, so it makes it interesting, unbalanced, but balanced gameplay.
I think movement is a little bit of an issue, though. I'm not entirely sure how do you kind of go about fixing that? Because, like, pointing is one thing, but you can't really point, it's hard to point just, like, directly where you're going to go, and you're paying attention to where you're. I don't know, just I feel like movement's a little
maybe. Do you think that multitasking is a skill that can be acquired, or that different people will be able to handle it differently? So,
yes.
For the way I'm interpreting Quincy's feedback is that having to try to do this, and then do this, and then make sure that she's being polite to everybody else, that she doesn't bump into them, and then move her body through all of that processing. As she's trying to learn the game, it's overwhelming.
And it's more of just like with everybody doing kind of their own thing, I feel like movement isn't as it's a little bit off. So people get to places. But I don't know, just it seems like it should be more sustained.
I don't know if it's just because we're using the sensory deprivation in our game, but my first thought
if you, before, and during the combat, if everybody has to close their eyes and already have their food space for moving to main line, and then move while you cannot be observing the other players to have that over that sort of stimulation. I mean, you'd end up probably bumping into each other a lot, but.
Another way that I was kind of interpreting that rule, because I did think that that one was a bit hard to interpret, but you did get better at the timing as the game moved forward. Like, you just mashed up the timing after one. But I think a better way to maybe do it is you did just a point. Like, instead of moving at the same time, you just 3, 2, 1, point in the direction that you're going in, and then you don't move until
yeah, I mean, it's okay to have a conversation.
Yeah. I think that when we imagine pointing, what happened is we would count down 3, 2, 1, and everyone would point the direction, and you wouldn't move. And you would kind of rationalize the points, like the directions, and then you would move after everyone has gotten that, like, down mentally. So it kind of removes the, like, the bumping and the knocking, and it also allows people to kind of, like, reconcile their choices.
And the way that it emerged from y'all's internal playtesting, do you think that that would emerge as other people would play more? I mean, if we hadn't stopped to give feedback yet and hadn't stopped to have this conversation and let them play through 2 or 3 more times, we would have to speculate. Would they have figured it out on their own to just point to you, hey guys, let's not move and point at the same time. Let's just point and then take a beat and then see.
I know that's how it was born in our mind. It was kind of created out of this, like, everyone has that natural, like, hesitation. And because of that, we wanted to eliminate that.
Would there be language that you think could be used to express the 1, 2, 3 point? And then after everyone's finished playing, then move?
As long as it's clear that you couldn't change your mind between pointing and the actual movement.
I think it's kind of like when you play a board game, you have like the sheet that says like the reference size steps or the phase, right? Like you could do like first everyone points, and then you reference size, and then you, and like adding that kind of like 3 steps would create the need for.
Yeah.
As we played it, it definitely became more natural, so I thought it was okay. The orcas felt, because they weren't the ones counting, but.
Yeah, it became fun once you could move into space quickly after the 3, 2, 1, but that did take, I wouldn't say very long, even though like 3 or 4 times after playing, you kind of understood how to move into space. So the pointing to me, like, kind of takes away a little bit of fun because I like the movement interaction, kind of quickly, think quickly, and on your feet, like, then I have to learn how to do those actions. I'm not exactly sure about the point personally because I enjoy, like, the kind of messing up and being like, oh crap, I didn't do that right. I like that aspect.
I'm excited for sure. I think, like, the pointing, I take away a little bit of fun out of it. It's not that good, I guess, like, bump into people a little bit. Like, you see the person moving. I think what I was trying to say is people point at different speeds or different times, and I feel like some people will, like, adjust. Like, they'll be like, oh, no, I was actually pointing over there. Or, like, it just adds this layer that I don't think is really necessary and kind of is the reason. But I think
it teaches a lot about it. Hesitate, observe each other, and I think putting maybe some sort of dialogue in the instruction about that, like in this game you are going to stall and you will learn how to not hesitate, get objectives and not hesitate, and move in secrecy with the 4 other players. And I think learning how to do that is awesome for this game. That is like an exercise trying to get to know each other better. You can all secretly move together on 1, 2, 3, like that's a huge feat. That's something that any performing we want to be able to do, so.
Having had this conversation, can we observe you guys play again with this in mind?
Yeah, I would say go for it.
go a couple more rounds? And I have one suggestion. What if, kind of related to what you were saying, what if the countdown was not as loose? What if it was a rhythmic situation where it constantly went and you had to move on that rhythmic count? So 3, 2, 1.
So it would be possible to have like an interval, what do they call those? Interval workout timers.
Yeah.
I mean, even a metronome.
Yeah, metronome.
Oh, also, is it 3, 2, and then you move on one, or is it 3, 2, 1?
Part of it was like, once you got the game down, you could speed up, and it became hell for the workers. Yeah, also for the zookeeper. It was like you had to do, like, the game was 2 minutes. And, like, however many turns you want to take in those 2 minutes, you could. And then, like, as the zookeeper, you'd start going 3, 2, 1, go. Yeah. I like that piece, though. Like, yeah. It has fun.
So, I do actually have a
strategy of the zookeeper to go quickly, 3, 2, 1, go. The workers are not ready, right? So they're off that map.
Yeah. That's good, man. Better, it's like easier to go faster because it was. I felt tripping so many times.
We can plug that into the big speakers. So it's actually audible.
Are you guys ready to play?
Okay.